cumulative and read lips.
I thought I heard you, but I came up here.
No, not me. Gargoyles.
Gargoyles? They talk to you?
Everything talks to me. Windows, statues, bells, my friends. No, that's stupid.
No, it's not. I like your friends. Have you lived here a long time?
Whole life.
Really? That seems like a wonderful place to live.
Yes, but in winter, cold. Can see all from up here. City gates, river sand.
Yes, it sparkles in the light. Small problem. I'm afraid of heights. Thank you. You're very strong.
Yes, I am.
Still, I'm glad I can get you to see things down there.
But instead, I see my charge has distracted you. Quasimodo, you shouldn't Don't you have duties to perform?
Yes, master.
Don't stray too far. Filling the boy's head with dreams?
No, just thoughts. Nothing wrong with thoughts, is there?
That depends. You see how impressionable he is. Little more than a child.
Looking at him, I don't see a child.
But you are, in a way. You indicated a willingness to learn. And a soul that wishes to be saved is already halfway there. I can instruct you in the Gospels. Share with you our Lord's grace. You could come here every day, or better perhaps, you could stay.
Stay?
In the cathedral with me.
I don't think that would be a good idea.
No?
I see the way you look at me.
How dare you! Your soul is so unclean you cannot imagine the goodness in others. I should have known no gypsy would truly want to be saved.
I don't think I'm in need of saving.
Of course not. Your kind never do. Captain! Friend to you, but I warn you, I can also be a terrible enemy. Your grace, escort the gypsy out of the church and make sure she never set foot here again. If she does, she'll be arrested. Quasimodo, this girl.
She was nice to me.
Was she? And what do you know about people and their feelings, my boy?
Feelings? Nothing.
Quasimodo, do you ever have thoughts? Impure thoughts?
Impure?
A boy like you, with a Roman body, possesses these urges and ideas that come to a young man. You must stop them. You must stop these feelings. You must not follow in the footsteps of your father.
My father?
He was weak, and you have his corruption inside of you. Quasimodo, I'm warning you about this girl. She's dangerous. She was put in our path for a reason, to tempt us both. Promise me you won't think of her again.
Won't think?
Promise me!
I promise!
Good. So then, we're well rid of her. It's just the two of us, my boy. You and I against the world.
Yes, master.
That's a good boy. Now sound the bells and send the city to sleep. Good night, Quasimodo.
Good night, master.
Despite his admonition to Quasimodo, Frollo himself did not stop this.
He began to walk the streets, night after night.
Unable to bring himself to return alone, dark.
He barely knew what he was looking for, but he could not resist.
Oh, I saw her everywhere.
Those us in time old Phoebus.
Until one night, walking down an unknown alley.
He came closer to the most unsavory part of the city.
Passing waters seemed racing in the shadows.
He heard the sound of distant music and laughter.